Hey everyone! In our recent videos, we've been exploring Flipper Zero and analog sensors. Today marks the final video in this series. If you haven't seen the earlier videos, I highly recommend checking them out. In this episode, we'll be using Flipper C code to read sensor data with the help of the Furry HAL ADC library. Writing a C application is often more complex than using JavaScript, but it enables your application to be added to the official store, and it grants access to Flipper features not yet available in JavaScript. Feel free to reach out on my Discord server if you need any assistance. We'll begin with a C program that logs analog sensor voltages, then we'll modify a program to render the position of an analog joystick. Let's get started. I've set up my development environment with Visual Studio Code and a copy of my firmware. I'll put a link to my wiki and a video in case you need directions. I've created an ADC folder under Applications Users with the default application.fam file. I set my app ID to ADC_demo, and I set the entry point to ADC_demo_app. In my ADC.c file, I've created that ADC_demo_app method. To read analog sensors, we use Furry_HAL, which stands for Hardware Abstraction Layer. And this will bring in the ADC code, which is the analog to digital converters. We use Furry HAL ADC acquire, and that will give us the handle. And then we call Furry HAL ADC configure EX, pass in the handle we acquired, our millivoltage reference scale, which is either 2048 millivolts or 2500 millivolts. And then we use the defaults for the remaining configuration settings. Next, we use Furry HAL GPIO init to initialize our pin. And we pass in a mode of analog, no pull-up resistor, and a very high speed. Now that everything's initialized, we call Furry HAL ADC read. We pass in our ADC handle, and we pass in the channel we want to read. In my previous video on analog sensors, we looked at this table, which shows the physical pin number, the GPIO pin name, and the ADC channel. Next, we call Furry HAL ADC convert to voltage, passing in our ADC handle and that ADC value we just read. This will return the number of millivolts from 0 up to our scale value. When our application is done, we call Furry HAL ADC release, passing in our ADC handle. I'm actually going to change our loop to 60 so we have a little more time for it to run. And then I'll go to Terminal, Run Task, Launch App on Flipper. Make sure that QFlipper is not running. Once the application is launched, I'll connect to this serial port. You could also use lab.flipper.net/CLI if you'd like. And then I'll run a log debug command. I have wires connecting to PA7, 3.3 and ground. When I touch the PA7 wire, you can see the ADC voltages are changing. If I touch the positive wire with the other hand, we max out that voltage. And if I press the ground wire, we bring it down to almost 0 millivolts. This is an easy way to test ADC. Just make sure your 3.3 and ground wires don't touch each other. Next, we'll look at editing the flashlight application to support this dual axis joystick. And this joystick has two analog voltages, and that goes to pins A7 and A6. We'll start by pinning the existing ADC.c application, and then we'll open Applications, External, Flashlight, Flashlight.c, and I'm in Momentum firmware, so this application is under External. From our pinned app, we'll copy that Furry HAL include, and we'll put it into our flashlight application. Next, we have our ADC acquire and our configure. So we'll scroll down to the main application entry point. And right before the event loop, we can paste the code there. And then we'll copy that Furry HAL GPIO init line. And we'll paste that. And we have two pins. So we have PA7 and PA6 that we want to initialize for analog. And when our application is done, we're going to want to do that furry hal ADC release. So we'll put that after our event loop. And then near the top of our program is plugin state, which is our view model. We'll go ahead and add two floats, one float for the X voltage and one float for the Y voltage. Then back down in our main application, we call furry message queue get, passing a 100 millisecond timeout. And if no button was pressed, we want to go ahead and add the code to get the ADC voltage. And instead of float millivolts here, we want to use plug-in state and voltage X. And then we'll copy those two lines. We'll remove the int 16 off of the ADC value since it's already defined. Change it to channel 11, and that'll be our voltage Y. So now that we've updated our voltage X and our voltage Y, we're ready to go up to our view where we're doing our render callback. We'll go ahead and comment out the existing render code. And then we'll set a variable for our width. And we'll just set that to 128 pixels. And then we'll do our height, which is 64 pixels. Next, we'll calculate our X coordinate, and we want that to be a percentage of our width. So we'll use plug-in state voltage X, which is the value between 0 and 2048. We'll multiply it by the width and divide it by 2048. And then for the Y value, we'll do it with voltage Y. Finally, we'll go ahead and do a line center for X and Y, and we'll render an X character at the X and Y coordinate. And then from terminal, we'll say run task, launch app on Flipper. And then over on our joystick, when we go to the left and the right, but when we go down, it goes up, and when we go up, it goes down. So in our code for the Y, we'll do 2048 minus the voltage of Y, and that should invert our Y values. And then we'll go terminal, run task, launch app on Flipper. And now our X and our Y work the way we would expect. I'd appreciate it if you could please take a moment to like and subscribe. Now you know how to access analog sensors in Flipper applications using the furry hal ADC library. I use these same techniques to add support for an analog temperature sensor to the Unitemp application. Again, if you have any questions, please leave a comment here or on my Discord server.